Please subscribe according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
The Lord appointed 70 others to send them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs in the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this house.' If anyone is there who shares the peace, your peace will rest on that person. But if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborer deserves to be paid. Do not move about from house to house. Whenever you enter town, if its people welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick or there, say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not welcome you, go out into the streets and say, 'Even the dust of your town that clings to our feet, we wipe off and protest against you.' Yet know this, the kingdom of God has come near. Whoever listens to you, listens to me, and whoever rejects you, rejects me. And whoever rejects me, rejects the one who sent me." The 70 returned with joy, saying, "Lord, in your name, even the demons submit to us." He said to them, "I watched Satan fall from heaven like a flash of lightning. See, I have given you authority to tread on snakes and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing will hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice at this, that the Spirit submits to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Out loudly, because that is your part.
part. I love to tell people that worship in the Episcopal Church is not a spectator sport. It's that you have your role, and today you have an expanded role in the Eucharistic prayers we're going to be using today. So it's what I call a dialogue prayer. And because it is a dialogue prayer, it doesn't lend itself to singing. So that's another slight change to the liturgy as we use the prayers. We're going to be singing less of the liturgy only when we use the prayer. And certainly when we go to a different prayer, we go back to our usual liturgies of 8 and 10:15 at the end of the summer, we'll be singing the 10:15 like we normally do, which I love to do. So there's your liturgical lesson for today, and kind of a heads up on what we're going to be doing, at least for the next month or so. Now, moving on to the gospel, that gospel that I've read is commonly called the sending out of the 70. Okay, remember to put this in context. Last week we read the gospel, and Jesus sets his face to go to Jerusalem. For him, Jerusalem is that city of God, it's that city of destiny, and he and his disciples resolutely set their face to go there. It will be the place of Jesus' final conflict and his final triumph as well. So, Jesus gathers 70 of his followers. He sends them out two by two on ahead, something of what you might call an evangelical road trip. 70 in all. Well, keep in mind that the disciples, that collection of people that follow Jesus, is much more expansive than just the 12 apostles or the 12 disciples. 70 all told. It's a large group of varying sizes, both male and female, as Luke takes time to point out. Now, this large group of Jesus' disciples, it does include the 12, but also so many more. And that's what stands out in this story. It's the expansiveness of drawing others in and the trust that Jesus has in them. So, when Jesus shares the good news, he says, the kingdom of God has come near. And he includes many others in getting that word out. Well, why 70? Well, in so many other things in the gospel, you can attach some symbolic significance to this. 70 was the number of men that were chosen by Moses during the Exodus. You may recall this story, it's a fascinating story, but Moses and the Israelites are in the middle of the Exodus, and they get bogged down. They're not going anywhere, because Moses is spending all his time dealing with the problems of the people. The story for Numbers is that Moses was spending all his day dealing with conflict. The people were lined outside of his tent. And his father-in-law, Moses' father-in-law, takes him aside and gives him some advice. This is crazy. We're not going any place. Have some people help him. So then the Lord poured his spirit out on 70 others. And Moses and the rest of them were able to get things accomplished together and move forward. 70 is also the number of the Sanhedrin, that high Jewish council in Jerusalem. And 70 was also, at the time that Luke wrote this gospel, was believed to be the number of all the nations in the known world. So it fits in well with Luke's story of the gospel. 70 means this mission is of God, that is for everyone, for every race and nation, and that it is good, and that we are in this together. So, go on your way, travel light, and say, the kingdom of God is at hand, or the kingdom of God is near. Now, by kingdom of God, Jesus means God's world is just not up there someplace in heaven, but God's world is right here and right now. And today, we might say something like this, the kingdom of God is at your doorstep. It is that close, and it is that real. It's sort of like UPS leaving a package at your doorstep. It's kind of an exciting thing to find it left there. There it is, right at your doorstep. You can pick it up, or you can step right over it. Either way, the kingdom of God is still at your doorstep. Now, some will respond to the reality of God's way in the world, and some won't respond. So the success or the failure of that communication does not determine your place in God or your place in eternity. God takes on that responsibility. Just rejoice that your names are written in heaven. Remember how it was when we were kids, we would get ink, we'd write on our hands, we'd draw pictures, or we'd write names on our hands. I imagine that that's the same way with God. You have been, your name has been written on God's hand by God. Every time that God opens his hand, there's your name, right there in front of God. Now imagine that every person you have ever met, or every person that you will ever meet, your name and theirs are written on God's hand. Never, ever be washed away. So rejoice that your name is written in heaven. And so then, at the end of the liturgy, you will hear these words, or words like this, really every Sunday, or at the end of every liturgy. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Essentially, that's exactly the same thing that Jesus tells 70 of his friends. Only now, you're the ones that are included in that mission. You're the ones. These words have been attributed to St. Francis. St. Francis said, proclaim the gospel wherever you are and whatever you do, and at all times proclaim the gospel. Only use words if you have to. So Jesus' mission is your mission. Jesus' life is your life. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. And the kingdom of God is literally at your doorstep. Rejoice that your names are written.